Started, sir.
Okay. Class 11th. And let us start now. We make a new notebook for this. Or wait a second, let me go to some other place. Yes, this is better. Here I have already done some work, so I think I can tell you from here itself. Already I have made some
sir, wait, lecture sir, plan. We will write, sir. Explaining.
No need to worry that much for writing. You can take the screenshots always, right? You just keep on listening and you can take screenshots. So oblique collisions, and in oblique collisions, first I will be taking the case of single impact. You can see here, wait a second, let me take the laser pointer. This single impact cases. Single impact in oblique collision, sometimes we can have case of multiple impacts at the same time. I can give you one example where multiple impacts are acting. Let me show you that. This is also single impact. This is multiple impact. One body is colliding with two at the same time. One impulse from one side, another impulse from the other side. This is also one ball is colliding with two balls at the same time. So sometimes there can be multiple impacts. This case also we can treat as multiple impact. Why we can treat it as multiple impact? Because one tension will be acting from above, and one will be along the line of impact along the line of impact. So there will be two impacts acting at the same time, two simultaneous impacts. So it is possible to have two impacts, but this is also, I can say, double impact only. Why? Because when this ball collides with this wedge, then wedge will feel some impulse from below also. So in wedge surface, two surfaces will be having impulse, one from below and one from above. So there can be multiple impact cases like this. And now let us come back to single impact case. Single impact is when, just briefly I have told you last time also, that when one ball is coming with speed u, right? And other is just at rest. This one is at rest here, B. Can you see it? B is at rest. And A is coming with speed u. I'm saying target at rest. The target is at rest. And this disc or the ball, which is coming with, I think I will better consider it as a disc. If I want to consider it as a sphere, then I will consider it in free space. Okay, as if the collision is happening in free space. There is no gravity, there is no ground. Or I can take as if these are, this is a carom board, frictionless carom board. And these are just two, what we call those things?
Coins
of the carom board. So from one we are hitting, right? One is striker, other is coin, right? Let us think that way. So this is coming with velocity u, and other one was at rest. How to, some things first you should be knowing. These terms, line of velocity. Line of velocity means if I take this line, which is in the direction of initial velocity, passing through the center of the one body. Passing through the center of the one body, if I draw a line along the line of initial velocity, then that line I will call as LOV. I will represent it as LOV, line of velocity. You can see it here, right? And another I want you to remember is impact parameter. Impact parameter is the distance between the line of velocity, LOV, and this B here. Can you see it? What does it mean? One is line of velocity, which is passing through the center of one body. And another is parallel to line of velocity, which is passing through the center of another body. Okay, so these two are the lines of velocity, C1 and C2, center of one and center of other. The distance between these two is impact parameter. Or I can simply say, if I take from C2 itself, and from C2 if I draw a perpendicular on line of velocity, then that itself will give us B, impact parameter. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
So once you understood impact parameter, also you understood, I think, line of velocity. It is just, line of velocity is my term only. And I will, everybody, this is not standard terminology, but I will call it as LOV. Okay. So it will be easy for us to write it, understand what I am, when I will be saying LOV, you will be understanding what does it mean. So now when two bodies collide, this is the diagram, this below diagram, you can see, this is a diagram during collision. In above diagram, what to notice? You notice U is given, R1 given, R2 given, and B is not given, but we will find it out. In the next diagram, we will find it out. How to find B? Now, in the next diagram, you see, this is LOV, and this from C to center of the second body, if I draw a perpendicular on LOV, then this will form a right-angled triangle. Right? You can see this right-angled triangle formed here or not?
Yes, sir.
This right-angled triangle here. In this right-angled triangle, B is acting as a perpendicular, and C1, C2 is acting as a hypotenuse, right?
Hypotenuse.
So C1 to C2 distance. What will be C1 to C2 distance? R1 plus R2. So can I write this thing? R1 plus R2. Then I can write R1 plus R2 into sine theta is equal to B. Are we able to obtain the impact parameter or not?
Yes, sir.
So this is how we obtain impact parameter always. Whenever R1 and R2 is given, we can quickly and easily get the impact parameter. Just first, we should know one thing, angle theta. Angle theta was not given to us. You can see it was not given. Okay. How we determine angle theta? So first we made the diagram during collision. After making the diagram during collision, in that two things are important, LOV and LOI. Line of impact. Line of impact is nothing but just join the center of these two lines. Join the center of these two bodies and extend the line. Joining the center and extending the line, that is becoming line of impact, or we call it as normal axis, or I will simply call it in short form N-axis. N-axis, normal axis, line of impact, I will use these words in these terms interchangeably. Tau axis, tangential axis, this is perpendicular to this. This is tau axis here. You can see it? This is tau axis, right? So, now I will be taking the cases, very simple cases we are taking. See, first of all, we are taking only single impact case. In that also, we are taking which case? When the target is at rest.
In that also,
we are taking which case again? When the body is frictionless. So when we discuss oblique collisions, we simplify it a lot. Otherwise, if you want to make a complete complicated case, then there will be so many things possible. But okay, we will not be discussing those things right now. Right now, simplest possible case. First of all, these all assumptions made. One assumption, single impact. Second, target is at rest. Third one, frictionless surfaces. When surfaces are frictionless, then wonderfully we are getting these two simple equations. One equation, second equation. Very simple. V1, velocity of 1. V means what here? V means after impact. I will be representing V for after impact and U for before impact. After and U for before. U for before and V for after. Okay. V for after and U for before. So, after impact means it will become, wait a second, let me see once again. Yes, here. V1 is in which direction, I don't know. But I know one thing, that its tangential component will remain same as before. Why does the tangential component remain same? What is the reason for that? Can somebody tell me the reason why the tangential component remains same?
Collision occurs only on line of impact.
Sir, there is no elasticity.
I have drawn this diagram separately here. If I draw the normal direction is acting this side or not?
Yes, sir.
Normal direction will be acting this side, right? Along the line of impact. So,
if I take perpendicular to it,
there could be friction. But now friction, I said already, that frictionless surface. If frictionless surface, then perpendicular this side along the tangential axis, there is no force along tangential axis. No force or no impulse. Same thing. No force, then obviously no impulse also. No force along tangential axis. And if there is no force along tangential axis, then momentum will be conserved along tangential axis. Momentum will be conserved, or we can say velocity will be remaining same. Will be conserved. But for whom momentum will be conserved? Only we are talking about this single body. We are not talking about many bodies here, just for this single body. Only for this single body, the momentum will be conserved along the tangential axis. But for the combined system, we have other way to tackle. First, I will tackle how to tackle single body, individual. So these two equations, which I am writing in the left side here, V1 tau is equal to U1 tau and V2 tau is equal to U2 tau. These are by understanding that moment, yes, individual bodies. Individual bodies momentum along the tangential axis will be conserved. So their velocity, one means velocity of one, initial velocity of one or before impact velocity of one along tangential axis is equal to after impact velocity of one along tangential axis. Similarly, V2, second body. For second body, along tangential axis is equal to after and before are same. After impact, same as before impact. They do not change. Second thing I recommend you to make the diagrams this way only whenever you face the situation of two body collisions. Exactly this way. You should make one LOV LOI, and you should make that during collision diagram. Even if they are making diagram somewhere else, you should make during collision. Especially this we are discussing for tangential axis when the target is at rest. So target is will be there only. We will know where it comes, when it will be coming, where what angle they will be making. We can find that. So theta we will draw, B we will draw, C1, C2, everything is known. Then little bit of tangential axis, normal axis. Once all these things are done, second thing I recommend you to represent velocities. U sin theta for this along tangential axis. Why is it U sin theta? Some of you may not understand it, but see, what was the velocity along this direction?
U.
This. Initial. Yes, exactly. This was initial velocity.
Initially U.
It was initial U. Now, now I have to take its component. If I take its component along the tangential axis, then
that
the tangential axis, it will become U sin
theta. U sin theta.
Along tangential.
U sin theta.
Therefore, this. Therefore, you can see here U sin theta. Can you see it?
Yes,
sir. U sin theta.
Yes, sir.
And if I tell you what is along the perpendicular axis, along the normal axis, then it will be slightly tough. I cannot
do that.
It is unknown. No. That was before. U cos theta was
before
striking. Yes.
Before collision.
Yes,
but after collision, it will be unknown. So after collision, I don't know. It is to be found. I don't know what is it. It is unknown quantity for me. But second body, the target one, I can assume another unknown V2. One choice is this. I can assume another unknown V2. But I don't recommend that. Although you can take V2 also. But it will be easier. It will be easier if I don't waste time in writing this thing as V1 along normal. And this as V2 along normal. In spite of that, I will be just writing V plus coefficient of restitution is E.
U cos theta.
E into U cos theta. Why I am writing E into U cos theta? You understand that? Because it was coming with what velocity towards it?
U cos theta.
Now it will be going away with what velocity? E into U cos theta.
U cos theta.
That must be the velocity of separation. It was velocity of
approach.
Velocity of approach along normal. And this will be velocity of
separation.
Velocity of separation along normal.
Along normal.
Separation and it is actually relative. Both of these are relative.
Relative.
And this is always along normal axis.
Normal axis.
Similarly, here also along normal axis. So once we know this thing, then why should we waste time? Why, if I know already that it is moving E into U cos theta faster as compared to first one, it has to move this much faster. Second has to move this much faster. Then only the bodies will separate. How much faster second should move? E into U cos theta faster. So its speed should be
cos
E into
theta
U cos theta plus V.
Yes,
speed should become E into U cos theta plus V. Is it understood
theta
or not?
Yes, sir. Understood,
sir.
Yes, sir.
Then very good.
Understood, sir.
Then we will now apply conservation of momentum along the line of impact for A and B, and we will get answer. And it is very easy to apply. Let us write the equation quickly. Let us say mass of A was M. Let us write something. What you would like to write it?
M1, M2,
we can write it. Right? Better to write M1, M2. So if I write that, then I will be getting M1 into what is along this normal V
cos theta
plus M2 into V plus E into
U cos theta.
That is final. Is equal to initial.
M1 U cos theta.
Very good. Very good. So how many unknowns are there in this equation? You can see easily. How many unknowns are there in this equation?
We can consider
just
it as
V. So it's not very easy. Very easy to solve. See how easily we are able to solve the oblique collision case, whether it is along tangential. That tangential was easiest. That we already found before. Already here only tangential we already found. What is the velocity of second body along tangential? That is zero because second was at rest. So it's initially it was
zero.
So finally also it will be zero. So V2 tau we know. What is V1 tau? That also we know. That is just
U sin theta.
U sin theta we got? Yes, U sin theta, right. We know. Now, this one, we still don't know this one. But in next step, we can get this. Just in next step. What is the value we are getting now? Let us write it down quickly.
M1 U cos theta minus M2 U.
M1
U cos theta.
Cos theta.
Minus
theta.
M2 into U cos theta
by M1 plus M2,
sir.
M1 plus M2. See, it is so easy. Is it not easy?
Yes, sir.
Yes, very easy.
U cos theta take common.
Yes. Now, here we can take U cos theta common. That task I am leaving for you. You can write it in easy form. you can write in this form. In what form you can write? M1
minus N2
minus
plus N2 into
M2 into E upon
M2E by M1 plus
M2 whole multiplied by
cos theta.
Cos theta.
That is V. In fact, this I will be needing. So I think let me write it in some this form. I will save it. I will need it later on. I will tell you why I need it. Here you observe M1 minus M2 into E. Here it has some significance. What significance it has? Here I will get two cases from it. Let me write those cases here only. Why should I wait for next? If M1 is greater than... my co-host, please can you mute him? Can you mute that guy? Who is that guy?
Yeah, I mute it.
Thank you. M1 is greater than M2 into E. If M1 is greater than M2 into E, then what happens? Then definitely V will be positive.
It
means the direction of V will be same side.
Positive.
But then V will be in the same side. V will be positive. But if M1 is less than M2 into E, then V will be negative. And one more interesting case here. If M1 is equal to M2 into E, the most interesting case, then V will be zero. What happens? Then first one will come to rest in that direction, second one will
momentum
move.
Yes, sir. Momentum.
Second one will move. If first one comes to rest, then does it come absolutely at rest, or do you say it has still some velocity?
It
moves along tangential axis. It moves along tau axis, and the second one moves along normal axis.
Normal axis.
When one body moves along tangential axis and other body moves along normal axis, then it becomes such a wonderful case. This will be moving with u sine
theta.
And what will be the velocity of other one? Other one's velocity will be, we found
e
plus
theta.
E
cos theta.
E into u cos theta. That will be the second body's velocity. Or we can say it is velocity of second body, and this is velocity of one body. Velocity of one and velocity of two. For which case? For the last case.
Yes.
When V is zero.
So
angle between them is 90 degrees. What is angle between them? 90 degrees. So here, let me tell you something. What we call this angle as? We call this angle as opening angle. Opening angle means it appears like this is like when it body comes and it hits a target, then target also moves and the body also, that body, projected body also moves. Then the angle between their velocities, we call sometimes this angle as opening angle. Okay. So this opening angle comes out to be 90 degree for one special case. When M1 is equal to M2 times E.
Yes.
Then they move mutually perpendicular. And if I give elastic collision, then also we can find out what happens for elastic collision. Then
E
M1 is exactly equal to M2 and E is just equal to 1.
Velocity
is it right or not?
Yes,
so means when the masses are equal, we already know that it is nothing new. When masses are equal, then velocities will be interchanged. First one will come to rest. Second one will be moving along the normal. But along the tangent, it will retain its velocity.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is very easy to deal with now. One thing. We have already discussed it and we did everything. Just what we need to do, we need to just remember this thing that here, how should I take the variables? If you remember this part, that I should take first one as V, and second one as V plus E into U cos theta, then our after that task will be very easy. We can get it in a very, very easy way. There's another way also. Let us say somebody wants to obtain by impulse equation. Then I told you already how to write the impulse. Impulse was equal to mu into U relative. You know that or not? Mu into U relative into 1 plus E. But now I will be taking not the complete U, only which U I will be taking.
Along
the impact axis, along the normal axis.
Because of this only,
we are getting this impulse. Impulse is only obtained because of this normal axis only. So understand this UN here, normal. Then this will be resulting in impulse. This formula, if you know, then it will be again nice only if you can remember.
It will be again. Yes.
Then from here, what will be
U
then?
Cos theta.
Then see, what will be velocity of one along normal? It will be U cos theta minus impulse upon M1. And what will be velocity of second along normal? Velocity of second along normal will be
M2.
Because on second body, if I draw the diagram for the second body, then on second body, impulse will be acting this side. And that impulse will be...
Direction.
Yes. This impulse will be responsible this impulse will be responsible for providing its velocity changing from 0 to v to n, and mass is m2. So definitely m2. We should get this equation only, right? And as far as the first body is concerned, for first body it will be opposite of that impulse, backwards. So if I write this impulse as this side and its velocity, how does it change? Its initial velocity was u cos theta
2 minus
finally it becomes v1n. I'm writing it as v1n, or I can write it as v, means last time I wrote it as v only, that v, yes. See, last time I wrote v1n as v. Okay, so okay, these both analyses are complete or not, means you can do in two ways. And what are the things that we should understand? There are so many things here coming now in this single page. Also there is a lot of information. I think you should just take a screenshot of this also, because there's a lot of information in this page. It will be helping you a lot during revision also. Take this screenshot also, right?
So we have written
already, very nice. And try to make create the difference between the first and the second way to do. Don't think these are here mixed. Let me try to make a demarcation. This is the first part here, and up to what it is first part, I think one way of doing I was taking up to, actually these are mixed here. I have done the analysis. This analysis was for the first part only, first case only, first way of doing the problem. This analysis for the data only, that's this one, right? And this comes from this place here, right? And this other analysis, remaining analysis for the impulse, second method. So it is like, we can say method number two, impulse method.
Yes.
But I think conservation of momentum method is already so easy that we don't even need impulse. But yes, better to always learn different methods, better to learn multiple approaches, second method, and impulse conservation of momentum, first method. So impulse method also, momentum conservation also. This method has, both method will give us same velocity of v will be same by both. But here in conservation of momentum, I already obtained up to the answer. In first, in second method, I just left it there only. And I did one more analysis. What is opening angle? And I told also that when m1 is equal to m2 into e, that is a special case. Then the angle between these two velocity vectors finally becomes 90 degrees. And also here I can add one more thing, that m1, when it is less than m2 into e, then velocity will become negative, means it will be moving backwards along normal.
Yes.
Along normal, it will be moving backwards. Yes, first one will be moving backwards along normal, right? Right. Now, some examples we can take on this, I think. After that, you can move on to the next question. Let me take some examples on this. One example is, one body is coming with speed. Let us take some speed for this. And speed is 5 meter per second, right? 5 meter per second. And second one is at rest. Both are identical bodies. Sorry. Both are identical bodies. Identical radius. Radius is r for one and r for the second one. And it is given that it was coming from this way, it was coming at it. So I hope you understand what I mean to say here.
Sir, means if I star.
Means if I produce it further forward, then yes, b is equal to r, because it is just touching. It is tangent, so automatically b will become equal to r. And given that collision is elastic and
friction,
masses are identical also, we can say these are identical. I can say just spheres or the disks are identical. If I say these are identical, then I don't have to say that masses are same. Masses also will be same. Okay, I'm just saying masses are same.
Can do theta also, we can find out.
But we have to find you have to look. First, you see what you have to find. Find velocities after collision, number one, along normal and along tangential axis, and net also we can find out. Net velocity also. In which form? In vector form. This is x-axis, this is y-axis. I want you to find out net velocity in vector form. number one. Number two, find impulse. Number three, find impulse during deformation. Number four, impulse during deformation. During deformation, work done by
impulses.
Work done by impulse. Wait a second, let me finish at least question. Otherwise, I will forget some points. Right now, everything is coming to my mind. Let me finish it at least. By the time you can think already, some things at least you can answer. If you cannot answer all the questions, at least answer.
No, sir, I was asking.
Right? Yes.
Initially, the second body was at rest only. Sir.
Yes, all that, if I don't mention, you take it to be at rest only. Second is a target is at rest, right? Frictionless surface also you assume automatically. These are the assumptions already taken. Mu is equal to zero everywhere. Whether these are kept on surface, that is there also it is zero, and mu is zero, gravity is zero, no need to take all these things. Gravity free space, or if it is a carom board, horizontal carom board on which frictionless carom board is here, then striker will collide with the coin, then also same thing only. We can deal with the same. Anyway, work done by the impulses, and also during collision, work done by the impulses during collision. Maximum elastic potential energy stored during collision. Number six, angle of deviation of A, how A will be deviated, at what angle A gets deviated. You understand the meaning of this? This is nothing but it is angle between, what do you think, what do you guess, make a guess what it will mean.
Open angle between what and what?
No. Angle after of deviation.
LOI and LOV.
Angle between velocity of A after impact, yes, and initial velocity of A before impact.
Before impact.
This means before it impact, was coming, yes, like this, and it went somewhere like this. So if I take this angle I can call as angle of deviation, whatever you name it, maybe delta, yes, or something. Delta for deviation. D for delta for deviation.
Light we get this.
So this is initial velocity of A, and this is final velocity of A. So angle between the initial path and the final path of A, that will be called as angle in by which A is deviated from its path. So we call it angle of deviation. Number seven, you want to find out angle of recoil of B. Now guess what angle this will be. Guess it. Angle of new terms are also coming. I'm giving you terms. This question is really very important. See, so many questions I have asked in this one single problem only. And it is a very simple problem. But we should analyze it thoroughly. We should be able to answer all of these questions quickly. This thing I am asking you is, when it is initial velocity of this line of velocity, LOV, with line of velocity, the second body will be, body B will also be moving in some direction, though. How B will move? This was line of velocity of A. B will move in this side. A will move in this side. Let us say it is velocity of A. This is angle of deviation delta. Let us call some other angle here. And what should I call it? Name something phi. And that phi is angle of recoil. That phi is angle of recoil of B. Because B gains velocity in this direction. Means, I think I should name it theta only. I already named it, no, before. That was same angle theta only. So let us call that angle. Let us call that angle only,
yes,
then.
Sir. That one is assumed to be theta.
Let us call same angle then. This is theta. So theta is angle between line of velocity and line of impact. This velocity will be in the direction of line of impact. So angle of recoil of B means it is nothing but angle theta. That theta we have to find, delta we have to find. Opening angle, I have given some name for opening angle, not given it. You can name something opening angle, omega or something. Whatever you want to call it, or theta plus phi. Opening angle will be here, theta plus delta. That will be the opening angle. These things we have to answer. There are 8 questions, but all of these can be answered in, I should say, within 1 minute time.
Few steps on this.
Okay, try now. Let us think. Think for some time. So you may find this tough in the beginning, but if you start analyzing, you will understand it properly. That this is not that tough. What should be our first step during collision diagram? That is our first step.
Yes, sir.
Let us move on to the first step first.
Here, M1 is equal to M2 E only.
Yes,
sir.
M1 equal to M2 E only, sir. Before we had to.
No, but don't remember that formula. Let us say we don't remember that in the exam.
Yeah, along normal.
And we want to derive it again.
Yes, sir. Normally only we have done, sir. We can find impulse.
Or elastic.
We can find impulse also.
Yes, sir.
Exchange velocity.
Every time we use, no, sir, exchange
yes,
velocity.
Yes, yes. This boy said, no, exchange velocity. That we already know from the last class. Last week also we have experienced.
Yes, sir, I was all saying
that when the masses are equal, yes, right. You're right only. When the masses are equal, then the velocities can be exchanged.
The velocity will be exchanged.
And only normal edge.
Yes, I'm saying.
Exactly right only. Exactly right only. So, then I can say that velocity, what is the angle? First of all, angle we should know, no?
Angle will be sin theta equal to r by 2r, sir.
Angle 30 degrees.
This is 2r. So sin 2R. Theta will be equal to r divided by 2r.
1 by 2.
So theta is coming out to be 30 degrees. One answer we already got. See, theta we got already. Theta is 30 degrees.
Angle of recoil of
V. So main aim was that you should know these different terms. But otherwise, see, you know should know what is angle of recoil. Angle of recoil. I just wanted to tell you what is angle of recoil. Although even if you don't remember this, no need to worry that much, because whenever this question will be asked, they will be specifying what they mean by angle of recoil mostly, I think so. They should specify. But otherwise, anyway, now you know that is very easy to obtain. Already we obtained 30 degrees, right? Quickly, in one step only. Second thing, for example, I may ask another question, what is impact parameter? But that will be R only. That also we can answer quickly. So,
it is R only, sir.
What is the opening angle? We cannot find quickly. That we have to first find out in which direction this moves. So, now
angle of deviation also we can find is
angle of deviation.
Deviation will be only tangential.
Because we know in this case that M1 is equal to M2 into E. So, total opening angle will become what? In this particular case, one will see along the normal,
90,
along the normal they will exchange the velocities. This is 30 degree angle. So, along this side, what velocity it will gain? It will gain
five
velocity simply. 5 cos
5
30 will be 5
root.
3 by 2,
sir.
And other side, it will gain, it will retain velocity.
5 by 2,
that will be 5 by 2, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Along the tangents, it remains same as before. 5 cos, u, what was it? U sin theta, u cos theta, I think.
U sin theta.
Yes, sir.
U sin theta, that is 5 by 2 only.
5 by 2 is constant.
That is 5 by 2.
Yes, sir.
So, and what, this only, and this comes to rest in this direction. Why does it come to rest in this direction? Because the velocities
elastic
are
collision.
Elastic collision. And masses are equal.
Then the opening angle now became, you can check from here. This is tangential axis.
90.
Yes, sir, 90
and this
degrees.
Is normal axis.
90 degrees.
So these 90 are 90 degrees.
Degree.
So
90
we
degree.
Came to know one more angle here.
So it will be 60,
angle.
Sir.
60.
This total we know. Total we know 90. Then delta we know. Angle of deviation. Angle of deviation.
It will be 60 degrees, sir.
60 degrees. This is coming out to be 90 degrees. So this angle of deviation delta will be just 60 degrees. Now maximum elastic potential energy stored during collision. Impulse. First, let's go for impulse. Impulse. No, velocity we obtained already. Velocity we obtained. What are the velocities?
We obtained.
Already obtained velocities. V1 was
mu cos theta.
V1 was 5 by 2.
V2 was 5 root 3 by 2.
This we obtained. This is also done. Now we are left with this impulse. Done. This done.
Impulse is mu cos theta.
Yes, sir. Impulse.
Done. Impulse. Impulse will be change in velocity. We can say change momentum.
Into
impulse
normal
axis.
this, yes, sir, if I write the diagram for the second one, if I draw the diagram, I decide velocity changes from 0 to 5 root 3 by 2. Mass of this side, I forgot to give. Sorry, my mistake. We cannot get impulse without knowing mass. Yes, let mass be m.
M.
We can write m into 5 root 3 by 2.
Then m into 5 root 3 by 2. M into 5
root 3 by 2.
So, yes, we got one more term here. We got impulse.
Impulse
also we obtained. That is just
during deformation also same, sir.
5 root 3 by 2 into m. Right. M. Now, impulse during deformation is not same. Not same. This boy said wrong here now. Up to this time, you were right,
sir,
everywhere. See what happens. Forget two dimension. Think as if it is just one dimension collision. In one dimension, also, if I ask you this question, what is the impulse of? I think you should remember that impulse during deformation was
P
just
initial
when
star, sir,
P I star P initial star to
to you.
Then I deformation is just P initial star only. It is just P initial star. It is just P initial star or not?
Yes, sir.
It will be just P initial star.
Yes,
that is impulse. So what is P initial star? That is mu into U relative. P initial star is equal to mu into U relative along the normal.
Normal.
Now this discussion is all along the normal. Okay. You remember those formula of coefficient of restitution? There were so many formula. ID.
IR by ID.
V final by V initial.
V initial. But this is so now along normal. Along normal. And moreover, relative also. Relative. And that too along normal. Then after that, some other formula are there like P initial star. Again, along
P final upon P initial star, along normal only.
Everything will convert along normal. If I have to write in terms of kinetic energy, then also along normal. Means I will write initial kinetic energy along normal and the final
root
kinetic energy
K.
along normal. Initial
root of star.
What is the kinetic energy lost in this case? All these formulae will become same
K
as before.
Star into 1 minus C
square. Ki star, but now not Ki star. Ki star is normal into 1 minus C square. That's the kinetic energy lost. So everything, all the formulae get converted into this. Now with along normal, we have to take the velocities. Along normal, we have to take kinetic energy. Along normal, we have to take the impulses and the momentum. Everything along the normal only.
Normal.
Right? So along the line of impact, we can say. Along the line of impact.
So if you use first formula, we can get easily, sir.
From which formula? No, I'm not. No, I wanted to analyze
it. Equal to IR by ID. Yes.
Wait a second. I just wanted to analyze it deeply now. I know that answer we can get by just very simple way only. But let me complete the analysis now. When I started it, let us complete it. Okay. So these formulae, you should be remembering again. All these formulae you should be remembering, right? These all. So, right? Our answer is obtained already. This is our answer here. This is our answer. Impulse during deformation is this. And that is nothing but what is it equal to? Tell me now.
M 5 root 3 by 4. Sorry.
M into U relative five along 5 root 3 by 5 root 3
root
by
three
2.
Two.
Into M by 2. Because mu,
yes,
mu was equal to
so,
M
square.
Mu was
two
equal to M into M upon M I plus
two,
M. That
sir
is M by 2. So this
I
is
do
the formula which becomes just 5 root 3 by 4 into m. Means impulse during deformation is equal to impulse during reformation. Or we can say this way also, that because in elastic collisions, impulse during deformation will be equal to impulse during reformation. So net impulse will be equal to double of this or double of that. So impulse during deformation will be equal to net impulse divided by 2. Net impulse will be already obtained before. So impulse during deformation, only for elastic collisions, I can say. Only for elastic collisions, it will be the total impulse divided by 2. Right? So
half of the dot.
Yes. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Right.
Understood.
So I think you know this part also now. Impulse during deformation also, you know. Work done by the impulses during the collisions. As you know, net work done by all the forces is equal to change in kinetic energy. What is the change in kinetic energy in this process? Total change in kinetic energy is zero. Is it zero or not? Because it is elastic collision already mentioned. E is equal to one.
Sir.
Elastic collision.
Yes, sir.
So work done by then net work done by these will be just equal to zero.
Zero.
Net work done. For a deformation phase, there will be, I think, some negative work done. And for reformation phase, there will be, again, equal amount of positive work done. And net work done will come out to be zero.
Zero.
We have quickly answered it. Only for which case I can say my net work done zero? Only for those cases.
Elastic.
Where, yes.
Elastic.
Otherwise, if it has coefficient of restitution given as E and you want to find out what is the work done, then work done will be equal to, we can say, negative of kinetic energy lost. As there is no kinetic energy lost, so work done will be zero. Work done is equal to change in kinetic energy. So work done will, work done by impulses will be equal to negative of change, negative of kinetic energy lost normally. Okay. So this is zero that we obtained. Fifth one left now. Maximum elastic potential energy stored during collision. When will be the elastic potential energy stored maximum during the collision? Can you tell that?
And
I think
change in kinetic,
if you know, energy. Think about that thing only when
during collision.
During collision.
Example when, of
when at the point of maximum deformation, yes, at the point of maximum deformation, at that point only, at the point of maximum deformation only, there will be this thing happening. Let us say this time they will be deforming during the maximum. During the maximum deformation stage. During maximum deformation. What happens during maximum deformation? The kinetic energy, part of kinetic energy gets converted into elastic potential energy. Part of kinetic energy gets converted into elastic potential energy and some part remains as it is. So at that time, I can treat it just like inelastic collision if I want to find out.
Okay.
So I can say M into UN is equal to M plus M. Both will be having at that time same velocity VN. But only thing is, everything now we are doing along normal because tangential doesn't even care about all these things. Tangential velocities are same as before. So along normal, we should write all these things now. Nothing changes in this oblique collision except that we start taking it like one dimensional collision along the normal. What is the velocity along normal initially? You already know 5 root 3 by 2. Then now it will be 2m into velocity along normal at that instant. When both of these are moving with common velocity vn.
Common velocity.
At that time, the maximum kinetic energy will be converted. Whatever maximum can be converted into potential energy, it will be converted. So what it will come out to be? Vn is coming out to be. And I already told you that I can find by this method also. How? During maximum deformation stage, I can take just by taking E equal to zero. Because at that instant of time, the bodies are not separated from each other. Their velocities are equal. And when velocities are equal, their relative velocity of separation is zero. So at that instant of time, what amount of kinetic energy will be lost? At that time, K initial star will be lost. Where will be that energy going to? That energy will not be, mechanical energy will not be lost. Mechanical energy will be conserved because it is elastic collision. But this will be converted into elastic potential energy. So elastic potential energy will be, simply if I have to write in one quick step here, I will be writing it as K initial star along normal loss.
Normal.
It will be equal to half of reduced mass into U relative along normal square. That it will be, simply half into mu into UN square. That it will be. Or here, if you want to obtain, here you can obtain first, you can write this formula, then you can write VN from here. After writing VN, what will be the energy? Energy will be half of M plus M into VN square. What was the initial energy? Initial energy was half of M into UN square minus this. This energy will be converted into elastic potential energy. Elastic potential energy. I hope it is clear now. Is it?
It's clear.
Right.
Yes, sir.
So, this is good. Next, we can take one example. Let us take for completely means we can say the case in which such condition of elastic collision, etc., is not given. And I don't want to ask many things because if you have done this analysis, then you can do all other questions. When they ask, you can answer those questions. Okay, one question is still pending here. Velocities after the collision in vector form, you are not able to tell me. You are not finding in vector form. You will still not get the answers. I have to write vector according to x and y given.
X and y.
So how to tell? I think I can tell by knowing that velocity of one was in which direction? That was in...
Velocity of one is in...
Velocity of one was making what angle here? What was that angle?
60 degrees.
60 only?
60.
And this time it was, I think, 5/2, I think.
5/2, sir. Yes, sir.
Let us take y-axis and let us take x-axis. Then velocity of one is equal to, vector form, is equal to v1 cos 60 degrees I cap. Yes. Plus
5/4 I cap.
60 degrees J cap. So it is 5/4 I cap.
I cap.
Plus
5/4 J cap.
J cap.
That is it at last. This is V1. And what is V2 similarly? V2 will be. This is
Y. This is V2 making. 30 degrees.
30 degrees this side, and that was a 5/3/2. So I can write V2 cos of 30 along I cap.
Minus sine 30 along J cap.
So it becomes what it will be finally?
15/4 J cap.
15/4 I cap.
I cap.
I cap.
Minus. I cap.
Minus 5/3/4
Minus 5/3/4 J cap.
5/3/4 J cap.
5/4 J cap. That is the final result. This is it. Yes.
Nothing, sir.
This is the final result. So we obtained the velocities also in vector form. No? Means somebody may ask you velocities. You know the answers also, but you may not get the answers if you don't write it in vector form properly. So you should know how to resolve into vectors, and then we will be getting this also, right? One more question, then we will move to the next part. One question is, let me ask for the same scenario only. This is the last question based on similar scenario. After that, questions could be different. This again coming with some speed, let us take. And what velocity it is coming? Let us take maybe 6 meters per second. It's coming at 6 meters per second. And the target is at rest, and the masses are, this mass is m, and this is maybe this is 2m and this is m. Coefficient of restitution is given as 1/4. Coefficient of restitution is given as 1/4, and let me give you directly myself only theta angle, rather than telling you impact parameter. I can give you impact parameter, then you have to find theta yourself. Take the impact, take the theta angle to be 37 degrees. This is angle between LOV and LOI. Okay. What we have to find? Find velocities after collision. Find velocities after collision. Let us do it now. I want to see whether you can get answer yourself or not.
What about radius, sir? Radii.
Identical masses and identical sizes.
Okay.
Do we need radius? We don't need radius. Why do we need radius?
Given theta, no,
I have given you theta, no? You don't need that.
Yes, sir. You have given theta.
That we need to find out the impact parameter. But here already theta is given this angle. Target was at rest. If I forgot to mention that. Target was at rest. Yes. Ask what you want to ask.
Sir, what was axis, sir?
What was?
X and y along axis.
Do one thing. Just find magnitude wise that is enough for me.
Sir, we'll take along.
Or means
okay, sir. Then find, it is 14 by 500.
Find angle also. If you are able to find angle of deviation, then you have already obtained the vector. I will assume vector is obtained already. Find delta and find these velocities in that direction. Velocity of 1 and velocity of 2. Velocity of 2 will be already along theta 37 degree. We already know that. There is no doubt about it. It is at 37 degree angle. That is velocity of 2. I hope you understand, right? Second will be along the line of impact only.
Hello. Got to be 14 by 5, sir.
V1. Which side is 14 by 5?
Body along the.
Sir, V1
along
is 14
the tangential. Along line of impact, sir.
Yes, sir. Along line of impact. For first one.
Along line of impact.
At 14 by 5 and 14 by 5. And along normal, it is 18 by 5, sir. Tangential.
Yes, sir. Sir, not 18, 20 by
and
5.
And second one, it was.
Along line of impact 8 by
5. Along line of impact it is 8 by 5. For which? For okay. First of all, what is tangential side? Tangential side is easy because that
18 by 5, sir.
18 by 5, sir. It is 6 cos, sir.
That's right.
That is 6 sine or cos?
6 is sine 37.
Anything same or sine 37 or cos 37.
So it is coming out to be 18.
18 by 5, sir.
18 by 5, sir.
By 5.
And this side I got 14 by 5.
This side 14 by 5, sir.
14 by 5.
This
14
side
by 5,
velocity
sir.
V.
Along the
and 14 this by 5. One is
14 by 5.
V plus 1 by 4 multiplied by. 1 by 4 multiplied by.
Cos
6 cos 37 degrees.
37 degrees.
That one
and
4
this
will
mass
get,
is
4, sir.
M.
That one.
This is M. Yes. And we are getting.
V equals to 2
m into v,
v plus equal to
m into v plus m into plus what is this coming out to be?
Cos 37 into 4 by 5, sir. That is
6 by 5,
sir.
6 by 5, sir. That is
6 by 5 is equal to 2 m times
2 m into v cos
2 m into initial was
6 into
37,
yes, sir. 24
by 5, sir. It is 24
by
5 by
5,
yes,
right. So I think we are getting V from here easily.
Yes, sir. 14 by 5.
That is coming out to be
14 by 5 we get, sir.
14 by 5.
14 by
14 by 5. 5
sir. 14 by 5, 5, sir.
That is
5,
V.
Sir. And
then
this one
we know what is V2 also.
4,
we know,
sir.
From there. This,
yes,
V2 will be. This is
V2.
V2
4
actually.
Will get. 4.
4
V2
sir,
we are
4.
Getting, yes.
4 sir. 4 sir.
Very good.
4 4
very
4.
Good.
Yes, sir.
And what about V1? V1
already
obtained 18 by 5.
Root.
That was already 18 by
18 by
5. We need to find.
Now we are left with delta angle. Delta, how to find deltas?
Angle.
V normal.
No, V1 is not 18 by 5. V1 is not 18 by 5. It is missing.
Along tangential.
But you said V1.
There are,
we are saying along tangential it is.
V1 tangential, but it is net V1. No, when I am writing this way, it means it is already net V1.
Okay.
Then how to find?
Okay,
see,
sir,
this,
okay.
This way we will find out.
Root.
18 by
vectors
5.
Vectors we can apply, sir.
And this
and
side
this
it is
14 by 5.
This is 14 by 5.
Yes, sir.
Sorry. 14 by 5, right?
We can apply angle theta and we can.
We know.
Tan theta.
Now also, how will you find?
What are you asking? So that means resultant angle.
I want to find angle also, no? Resultant is easy. Resultant now 14 square plus 18 square under the root.
Yes, sir.
Is slightly calculative, but okay, let us assume resultant obtained. How will you find out the angle?
Sir,
easily, this way. Find out angle, maybe find this angle theta
but
only.
No, sir. Tangential angle we can find, sir. Tan theta.
Find this angle only, maybe theta, then we can tell from here itself. Okay.
Yes, sir. Tan theta we get to be 18 by 14.
tan theta is equal to 9 by 7. After obtaining this theta,
yes, sir.
Theta or maybe phi, assume something else, maybe something phi, maybe whatever it is. Anyway, after obtaining this, what will be angle with this side that it is making, delta? That I can find. This angle will be this remaining extra angle.
I'm
assuming this is
minus 37.
Yes, sir.
So it will be phi minus 37 degrees.
Minus 37. Yes,
and
sir.
This one is 90 minus 5. Then delta is coming out to be adding these two angles. 90 minus 5 plus 5.
Minus 5 minus 127 5 minus 37 also will be 127 minus 5
which is one which thing what I'm saying
pi is only
five
up
minus
to
37 sir
90 minus 5 minus 37 that was up to the resultant no sir but we want only up to the line horizontal line
I want up to the horizontal line. Then I will be getting 90 minus 5
yes,
plus 5
minus
37.
Yes, sir.
Right?
Yes.
This was?
No, no, yes, sir, like that.
Delta is coming out to be 90 minus?
5 minus 37, sir.
No, sorry, 5. Oh, what am I doing? Sorry. Yes. Sorry. Yes, 5 minus 37. Obviously, 5 minus 37 will be the answer then. That will be delta. 5
yes,
minus
sir.
37 itself is delta, right? That is answer. If 5 minus 37 comes out to be negative, I think it will never come out to be negative. How can it come out to be negative? It has to go somewhere upwards, no? It cannot come out downwards.
Sir.
So, whatever it is, but it will be slightly
even
positive.
Even 9 by 7 is greater than 1, sir, actually. It is positive one.
It is positive only. So, 5
that
minus
is greater
37
than
45.
Is
45 degrees.
Yes. Right.
Greater than 45.
So, I hope you can do such questions now. So,
yes.
Easily.
That's
can you?
Yes,
right.
We
second, I want to discuss now this type of case when nothing is mentioned, just it is mentioned that there is one body coming with velocity u1, then going with velocity v1, coming with u2, going with v2. They collided in between somewhere. How they collided, what was the angles, etc. Nothing is given. But yes, one thing assumption is already here. That assumption is frictionless collision again. Collision is with frictionless walls. Only for that case, we are discussing it again. Or do we need that or we don't need that also? Let me check. No, yes, we need that. At least this I need. Mu is given as 0. Otherwise, this formula will also fail here. So this works only when mu will be 0. I have written one formula here. I will tell you how I will justify this formula. See, what is the impulse I am writing as J? J1 is impulse acting on 1. And J2 is I represent impulse by I also. But this is also standard notation. Books also will see sometimes they represent impulse by J also, right? So impulse acting on 1 is m1 into final v1 minus u1.
Vector.
It is vector form. It is already vector form. I cannot take magnitude wise. Don't think if I write it as 8 and I write it as 6, then I will say 8 minus 6. Not like that.
Sir.
I have to write in vector form. Is it arrow is there above it. So I have to write 8 cos theta I cap, etc. Means it has to be in vector form. Anyway, right now I'm not interested to write it. But when such question will be asked, at that time you have to write it in vector form only. So let us say you resolve it into components. They will be giving
anything,
something.
No,
maybe they will be giving some x axis, some y axis, so you can resolve into components.
Yes,
or they may have, already given like 2i cap plus 3j cap. If they have already given that way, then much better. If they have not given that way, they have given some angles, etc. Then you resolve into components. But finally, you write it in vector form. After writing in vector form, we know m1 into v1 minus u1. That is the impulse on 1. What is impulse on 2? m2 into v2 minus u2. Same way, then what will be the formula for coefficient of restitution? Formula for coefficient of restitution
yes,
will
velocity
be
of separation by velocity of approach.
Yes, and do you know one thing that magnitude wise J1 is equal to J2? Magnitude wise, actually, J1 will be equal to minus of J2 because these are same magnitude of impulses but in opposite directions. You know that these are internal impulses, net internal
okay,
impulse will be zero. One is not mass equal. Mass is maybe unequal
okay,
also.
Okay.
Why are you saying mass? This is just, wait a second, let me go back again.
Understood.
Impulse acting on this side or acting on that side, these are equal
it'll
or not?
Be
equal
opposite
and opposite.
Only, sir. Equal, yes,
action,
sir,
reaction, equal and opposite. Normal will be equal and opposite. So impulses will be equal and opposite, right? So here also, impulses are equal and opposite. J1 is equal to J2, but action wise equal. Then, what will be the E value? Quotient of restitution, we know this formula or not? V1, 2. Divided by u1 2 And this hole along normal, this hole along normal, along the line of impact. Means if I have to write V12 along normal, what I should write it as? I will write it as V1 along normal minus V2,
minus V2 along normal.
Along normal.
Along normal. That is what this means. What do we mean by U12 along normal similarly? Similarly, U12 along normal,
normal
minus
U1
along
normal
minus U2
along normal. Right. So, you know what this E means, right? And you know this formula also already. We know this from the last week also. We have done discussed it. But how to how to use it to find out the coefficient of restitution when such things are given? Everything is given in vector form. V1 given in vector form. U1 given in vector form. 2i cap plus 3j cap plus 5k cap, something like that. Then take the difference of those two vectors. Sorry, it should be vector. Vector 1 minus vector 2. Vector 1 minus vector 2. And that, wait a second. No need to take along normal now because I'm already taking dot products with J1. If I take that dot product of the V2, V1 minus V2 along J1, what will it give me? What will it give me? J is the line of impact. J is along the line of impact. And let us say this is the direction of delta, delta V, let us say, or V, V1 minus V2, let us say. V1 minus V2, not delta V. Delta V is different. It is not delta V. It is just velocity of final velocity of one minus final velocity of other. It is not change in velocity of any one body. It is just final velocity of one minus final velocity of other. This is this vector, let us say. If I take its component along the normal, then how to take its component along the normal? Its component along the normal will be equal to, if I take
V1 minus V2 cos
theta, let us say.
Angle.
But that yes, V1 minus V2 cos theta, I can also write it as V1 minus V2 into cos of theta into J1, I am writing extra. J1 is not there, but I am writing J1 also because dot product gives us J1. But that J1 will get cancelled out below also in the denominator. U1 minus U2, let us say it makes some angle cos beta alpha. This is alpha, let us say this was alpha, the other below was beta into J1. So J was making, what angle was J making with the our initial velocity? Initially, let us say it was U1 minus U2 was this side. And with that, it was making an angle, let us say, some angle beta, right? It was making some angle beta with that. Then I will be getting this as coefficient of restitution or not? V1 minus V2 into cos alpha into J1. Beta will be angle between the vectors. Wait a second, let me write, not here. Let me write it in this angle. Although it is obtuse, but no problem. But we have already one negative sign outside also here. I have kept one negative outside. So this will be giving us one negative sign because obtuse angle, but here also I have, so I think overall we will be getting it. Yes, these will get cancelled. So finally it will be magnitude wise, and J1 and J1 will also get cancelled at last. At last J1 cancels J1, and when J1 cancels J1, then what we are left with? Then we are left with just V1 minus V2 cos alpha upon V1 minus U2 cos beta. So we are getting the same thing which we wanted to obtain. We wanted to obtain this. So remember, V1 minus V2 dot J1 upon U1 minus U2 dot J1. Outside, or either you write outside negative sign, or you don't worry about negative sign. Take mod of this. Find out the ratio and take the magnitude. That will automatically give us coefficient of restitution. Is that okay? Ask what you are not understanding in this part. If you are not understanding this, then let me go backwards. You will understand from that. At least everybody knows this formula or not. V12 along normal upon U12 along normal, magnitude wise. Let us forget sign.
Yes,
magnitude
sir.
Wise. Is it right or not?
Yes, sir.
Next.
Yes, sir.
Next, can I write it as V1 minus V2 along normal upon U1 along normal minus U2 along normal? Can I write this or not? Yes.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Then can I write it as V1 dot, again magnitude wise, V1 dot n cap minus V2 dot n cap, normal, along normal, if I have to take component, then I can take n cap or not. Similarly, u1 dot n cap along normal, unit vector along normal, minus u2 dot
normal
n cap, right? But I know that normal impact n cap is nothing but same as impulse j cap also. Why? Because impulse axis and the normal axis is same axis, mm-hmm. not different axis. Is it right or not? Impulse axis and the impulse is acting along the normal only. So the unit vector along the impulse is same as unit vector along the normal. These are not different from each other. These are same in magnitude as well as in direction. Why these are same in magnitude? because both are unit. Cap is written above. Cap is capped above these. So these are unit only. And why these are also in directions same? Because both are along normals. So I can just write J cap as N cap only, or N cap as J cap only. So I can write V1 dot J cap minus V2 dot J cap upon U1 dot J cap minus U2 dot J cap, which I can further write as V1 vector, V1, V2 vectors, V1, all these are vectors, sorry, vector. V1 minus V2 vector dot J cap divided by U1 minus U2 vector dot J cap. And mod, don't forget where it is, mod. Or otherwise, you have to put negative sign outside, or you take mod only. Either you take mod or you put negative sign. J1. Impulse acting on 1, or I could write here impulse acting on 2 also. I could write J2 also. I could write J1, or I could write J2. No problem in that. J1 or J2. J1 or J2. That doesn't make a difference. Sign is only different, but I am already taking mod, so I don't care. Now, because I know that J will get cancelled out, so why don't I just write J only? Because no need to find unit vector. To find unit vector is tough, but to find the total vector is easy, because it is just M1 into V1 minus U1. You can see this here. M1 into V1 minus U1. So it is very easy, no? So this is very easy. Therefore, I'm thinking, why should I waste time in finding the unit vector? I have to divide by magnitude, and that otherwise also will cancel out. So therefore, I will be relaxed writing just V1 vector minus V2 vector dot product with J divided by U1 vector minus U2 vector dot product with J again, and taking mod of this 1 1. Is it understood or not? Tell.
Yes, sir.
I think simple only, not difficult. See, I know so this comes to mind that, oh, this is such a complicated formula of V1, V2. How can we remember these also many things? But it comes so easily from coefficient of restitution. You try to understand the logic behind it. It will be very easy to remember also if you understand the logic behind it. Okay. Now I will give you one question, and if you are able to answer that, then it means you have understood the essence of the formula. One question you have to answer. So it is given that two particles were initially moving with velocities. I am worried although while giving this question, because, you know, I'm thinking whether physically this situation will be possible or not. Okay, I'm giving some random vectors, but if physically it is coming out to be impossible situation, then you just forgive me. But I'm just worried about the physical situation can come out to be like, for example, E should be less than 1. So I'm thinking, will I make it E greater than 1 or not? Okay, I'm just giving you some vectors, and then you decide what we are getting. 2 I cap. Minus, or I told you some collisions can be explosive also. So if E comes out to be more than 1, then no need to worry. Then maybe it is explosive collision. So velocities of two vectors were given, 2 I cap minus 3 J cap. One vector has this velocity, U1 is given. Or we can say two balls were, or I can say smooth also. Balls or spheres or whatever, two small spheres were moving with velocities I cap plus J cap, 2 J cap, and I cap minus J cap, or 2 I cap minus J cap. Two small spheres were moving with the initial velocity is this, and their velocities after collision became I cap and J cap, or 2 I cap and J cap respectively. Find coefficient of restitution. I forgot to mention mass here. Mass I should mention, or maybe two identical small spheres. In the beginning, I am writing two masses, then will get cancelled out. No, if I give this way, two identical small spheres were moving with initial velocities I cap plus 2 j cap and 2 I cap minus j cap. Their velocities after collision became 2 I cap and j cap respectively. Find the quotient of restitution for the collision. Okay, so do it. Simple only. U1, U2 given, V1, V2 given.
Yes, sir.
One by seven. Okay, let me see if some other answers are also
four by
ready.
Seven.
4 by 7, you said. Anybody yes. else, please, please verify whether it is same answer or not. Please, anybody else?
Yes, sir.
Same only. Those who are not getting, for them, V1 minus V2. What will be V1 minus V2? V1, V1 this and V2 this. 2 I cap.
2 I cap minus
J cap. Cap.
What is U1 minus U2? U1 minus U2 is.
Minus i cap plus 3 j cap.
And this will be valid even if I give k cap component. Don't think that k cap is not there, so it means it is not valid. If I give,
we can do, sir,
I,
but not
then also same way only. Same way only. What is j1? Yes. Is in some impulse you take. For example, change in momentum of one body.
Mass into change in velocity.
Mass into change in velocity.
Into change in velocity of any one body. So V1 minus U1. V1 minus U1 we can take. So I can take 2 I cap minus I cap minus 2 J cap. So it is just.
That is I cap minus 2 J cap.
Minus 2 J cap. So we are getting J1 also.
Yes, sir.
And next, you know, just taking that dot product is very easy task. I think everybody can take it easily.
Yes, sir, yes, sir.
And then we can get E
we get
by
4 by 7.
This
sir.
Form. Same. So answer is coming out to be.
4 by 7.
Same
okay, I just believed yes, you. I don't know if it is wrong or right, but I think you have done right only.
Directly.
Let us analyze in a center of mass frame. What happens when the target is at rest in center of mass frame? And then after that, I will tell you, I will give you one more idea here. Angle of deviation, I told you, before. And I told you how to find also angle of deviation. But now I will give you a completely yes. different way to find out the angle of deviation, a completely different method. So this diagram I made for that only. So yesterday I prepared it up to 3 o'clock in the night. All these things, I thought maybe it will make it easy. Is it making it easy for you or not?
Yes,
to understand, I
yes,
think,
sir.
Because
sir.
I will not.
Easy, sir.
I will also not waste my time in writing everything, and everything will be already written in front of you neat and clean. So I think it will be easy if I can prepare lectures in this way. I can do it. I can try that way. Okay.
Very
so
understand.
But although for me it is becoming very tough because it is becoming very hectic. I have to do a lot of work in that. But no problem. Anyway, I will do it.
Actually,
I will. Today yesterday I slept late. Actually, in the night I got this idea. If I would have got yesterday morning only, then I could have done in the daytime itself. But I got this idea in the night. Normally, I prefer to sleep at least 7 hours normally, but these days I'm not able to sleep for 7 hours because of some other work is also there, which is going side by side. So as a result, I'm not sleeping for that. But yes,
I am sleeping only 5 hours.
Very less 5 hours. Try to if see.
5 hours,
although depends from person to person, there are some students those who will not get tired by sleeping for 5 hours. Also, if you are like them, then okay, I think no problem. You can do that also. Sometimes, not always, because otherwise your health will be suffering.
Max
so, but normally I think 7 hours you should try at least for staying healthy. 7 hours sleep should be there. Okay, anyway. question number.
Normally,
sir. No, I know that there are some students who really sleep for 5 hours only. But I don't know how they manage. But they do it for some time. And sometimes then they sleep for more time. Then they are able to compensate that 5 hours also. So they do like that.
It's a 10-hour sleep.
In classroom, they are sleeping.
In classroom, they are sleeping.
They are sleeping.
Okay, somebody is sleeping in our class also, sir. No.
What is the point here? I cannot even see you are sleeping or what you are doing. I really don't know now. Okay, let us come to this. A special case when the target is at rest. So when the target is at rest, and in that I'm analyzing from the center of mass frame. Last week I told you something related to center of mass frame, very small introduction I gave you, that if one body comes and collides with the other body, I gave three diagrams, you remember? Those diagram was during collision. Sir. Something like this. Let me make three diagrams, those three diagrams again today. I will copy it. And then I will make one diagram here somewhere. And then again, copy of it here also. This. And then maybe after collision, they are going somewhere here. And one is here. Right. This is how they are going. And during collision, how they are going? One is coming this side, then going that side. No, it doesn't appear to be going that side.
Some deformation will be there.
I have to, maybe wait a second. I have to change. I have to change orientation a little bit so that it appears like going.
Yes, sir.
This way, can it, wait a second. It comes here, then goes there, right? It comes here and goes here. Huh, it is possible now. It is possible. It is going in this way, and yes, then sir. This will be going in this way. Yes, now it appears to be going here, then going here, and then it is right. Colors, now I will let us say during collision, they are having, let us say, red color. During collision, let us change the color to red. And this was before collision. One color is okay only. One color I will be taking for after the collision. So after the collision, let us take their color to be some other color, maybe blue. Right. So see, now this is here and then going there, right? And this one was coming here, opposite direction, their velocity is always in center of mass frame. Their velocities can never be in the same direction. They have to be
up. Yes, sir. They'll
exactly
be
opposite. Exactly opposite
to
also.
Cancel momentum.
To cancel the momentum, otherwise moment, because center of mass frame,
sir,
is zero momentum frame. So that has to be canceled. U1 star and U2 star.
It will be
and this U2. One will become V1 star. And this one will become here. V2 star. Right. So this is happening, right? There is one blue ball which is coming, colliding with the other ball, which is black color. So that black color ball went that side, right? Now, the point is that during the impact, what I told you last time, I think I told you that I gave you that those ideas, no? Tan theta, I told you something about tan theta also. Angle of incidence and angle
It will be greater than one.
Yes, sir.
Something.
It will be exactly equal if it is equal to one. Yes.
If it is elastic collision, then the one thing I did mistake here. Angle of line of impact will be somewhere different. Line of impact will
sir,
not be in this.
It is tilted this side actually.
Line of impact will be something like this. So this is, let us say, line of impact. LOI.
Yes.
Then this is angle of incidence. Maybe I. This is angle of reflection.
R.
And here it is angle of incidence
R.
I. And this is angle of reflection R. So I told you this relation. Tan R will be equal to, you remember?
Tan I.
Tan I divided by
tan
E. Valid for which case?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Smooth.
Collisions.
Smooth walls. Smooth. The colliding bodies should be smooth only.
Yes.
Then only it is valid.
Yes,
right. So, and it is in center mass frame also. Also center mass frame. And this is line of impact. It is happening in center mass frame. Always it will happen like that only. And V1 star I can write in center mass frame as U1 star into E. And V2 star I can write as V1.
V2 star also U2 star into E.
U2 star into E. Yes, U2 star into E. So U2 star, you know, U1 star means here. U1 star means U1 with respect to C. And U2 star means U2 with respect to center mass. And similarly, V1 star means velocity of 1 with respect to center mass. Velocity V2 star means velocity of 2 with respect to center mass. And also, V1 star, right. UC, what is UC? UC is same as VC. Center mass velocity cannot change. That will remain same.
Yes, sir.
And that will be equal to M1 U1 vector plus M2 U2 vector divided by
M1 plus M2.
M2. M1 plus M2. Also, U relative. U relative is, this is relative only. So relative will be just equal to, I will write it as U12 maybe, or I will just represent U, U also. Similarly, V relative also will be V12 I will represent sometimes. And sometimes I will represent just, and I will represent that along normal also. Along normal, U relative is U12, let us say, along normal. And let us say it is UN and it's VN. That will be equal to what? That I have a formula for that. I think mu into UN. First of all, VN will be equal to E times UN. Same way. VN will be equal to U times UN and mu into UN is equal to M1 into U1N and it is equal to M2 into
V1
U2 normal. These are the formula which we are having. So keeping this formula in mind and keeping this little bit idea in mind, some other things I want to add here now. Do you know that we have a relation? If I want to find out the vector relation of final velocity can be written as V1C plus VC. And similarly, initial velocity can be written as U1C plus UC. But advantage is that we know that C in center of mass frame, VC is equal to center of mass velocity will not change if the momentum is conserved. So VC will be equal to UC. As there is no external force acting on the system, no external force acting, then velocity of center of mass will remain same. These two are equal. It means if I want to represent diagrammatically, let us say this was the velocity of center of mass, UC. And in that, I added one more velocity that is added as U1C, right? But UC is also equal to VC. And in VC, what I'm adding? V1C. But V1C is in different direction and U1C was in different direction. U1C was in this direction and V1C went to some other direction at some other angle with the initial direction. At some other angle it went. Let us do that here also. In which angle, which direction it can go? I don't know in which direction it can go, but it can go in some direction. Let us call this angle as delta. U1 is going this side and went that side. So it means it is delta star. Star means center mass frame. It is angle of deviation in the center mass frame. Delta star is angle of deviation in center mass frame. Of which body? You may think it is different for different bodies, but no, this is delta star, then this also will be delta star. So whether we talk about first body or second body,
yes,
both
sir.
Will have same
because
angle of deviation.
Because it is 180 minus of 5 plus R.
Yes, exact. That is the reason. So let us say yes. Somebody has given us that it has, but what will be the final speed? If coefficient of restitution is given, E is given to us, then all I know is U1 star times E, or I can simply write that V1C will be equal to U1C into E. So U1C is fixed quantity. It means V1C is a fixed quantity magnitude wise, but not direction wise. Direction could be anything, but magnitude wise it is fixed. It means I can think of, it could be this side, or it could be this side, or it could be this side, or it could be anywhere. But one thing is certain, that it will be a circle of radius. What circle of radius? It will be circle of radius. U1, if I want to represent all these vectors by a single diagram, then I think I will represent a circle. Then all the vectors starting from here, this will be going to the tip of the circle. The tip of the vectors will be ending at the circumference. It is V1C.
Points on the circle.
Depending upon case, it could be V1C or it could be V1C, depending upon different angles of deviation, depending upon at what angle it is deviated. So it could be any of these. So now I will not choose all of these because it will become very complicated if I starting. Otherwise, also I cannot take all of these because there will be infinite vectors. That will be complete diagram of these vectors only. So out of all those vectors, I will be just choosing maybe for one particular angle of deviation. Let us take this angle of deviation as delta star. Then this is our V1C, or it is equal to E into U1C. See, notice I am making U1C bigger. Starting from here, it is going up to this place. See, I am making this bigger, but I am making it smaller because normally, if nothing is mentioned, if the collisions are not explosive, then normally E value will be 0 to 1 only.
Less than 1.
Therefore,
so it will be less.
So it will be somewhat less only. So I made it like this only, right? Now, having understood this part, but it could be anywhere else also. But what about in the ground frame? What is the angle of deviation in the ground frame? Angle of deviation in the ground frame will be angle between initial velocity vector and final velocity vector. That angle will be angle of deviation in the ground frame. What is the initial velocity vector? If you know, this total vector is nothing but U1 vector, I think. You know that or not? Starting from UC plus U1C. See, UC plus U1C.
Yes,
sir. UC plus U1C. Yes. That is this. Why I am breaking these into two parts, center of mass frame and this? Because in center of mass frame, the motion was easy to analyze. And therefore, I am breaking into two parts. One more thing. Center of mass velocity is same, common to both final as well as initial. So at least one vector will remain same. What part will change? Only second part will change. U1C will change into V1C.
Final velocity part.
That will change. So what will be the final velocity now? Final velocity will be sum of one part and the second part, which is changed. First part remains same, second part gets changed. This is V1 total. What is the angle of deviation now? This is delta angle of deviation. Can you find out angle of deviation delta?
Yes, sir.
Yes, tan delta can be obtained if I know tan delta star. How to find? I think, let me give some method for this.
Sine V1C.
I think I can get in terms of perpendicular upon. See, observe it.
I was trying to do that.
This is perpendicular and this is the total base. And I think
I can write
the perpendicular as V1C into sine delta star delta divided by UC or VC, same thing. UC or VC.
UC.
Plus,
yes,
plus what was that?
Sir.
So if somebody gives me the angle of deviation in one frame, then I can find out angle of deviation in the other frame. We can find it out easily. What is V1C into sine delta star? V1C into sine delta star will be E into U1C into sine delta star upon UC plus V1C will be again, E into U1C into cos delta star. Or E into U1 delta star, U1 star upon UC plus U1 star into cos of delta star, sine of delta star. There is one advantage of taking this star notation. No, it is already star written. No, when I say star frame, it is center mass frame. I don't have to put C again.
Then here the E should not.
E, sir.
Oh, you are saying E is missing. E, yes, E should be there.
Yes.
That is tan delta.
Yes, sir.
That is tan delta. So we are able to get, if I know in one frame, then I can get in the other frame. But you notice one thing. There will be some ambiguity. Ambiguity means there can be two possible cases. If somebody says this is delta star, let us say it is delta 1 star and it is delta 2 star. There are two possible values or not?
Obtuse and acute, sir. Two cases.
Yes, one is acute and one is obtuse. For both of these values, we will have same angle of deviation, but different velocities. This velocity will be small. One velocity will be from here to here only. But other velocity other velocity will be from here to here. See, so velocities are becoming different. One is up to this, and one is just ending up to this only.
Angle will remain same, sir. Angle.
But the angle of deviation will be same. So for a given angle of deviation, how many final velocities we can have? We can have two possible final velocities. For a given angle of deviation, we can have two possible final velocities. But for a given angle of deviation in the center mass frame, how many velocities we can have? For a given angle of deviation in center mass frame, we can have only just one unique velocity. But for
velocity.
A given deviation in ground frame, for a given angle of deviation in ground frame, we can have two velocities. But for a given angle of deviation in center mass frame, we can have only one particular velocity. Okay. So this part we understood. And here, this diagram I made here only, but I thought this diagram, if I directly show you, then you will not understand it. So I have just done this analysis here. Now you understand it here also. See what I'm doing here now.
Time
is up. So yes, you want to stop here? If you want to stop here, then also I recommend at least take the snapshot of this diagram also, so that tomorrow when I will be discussing on it again, at that time it will be very easy for you to understand. Take a snapshot of this and you try to analyze it yourself.
So can you show last previous page also, sir?
Last page also you can see here, this one.
Yes, thanks.
Okay. And you can write there, this is the angle of deviation in ground frame. This is angle of deviation in here in center mass frame. And right.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
The previous one, sir, for this.
Which one? Which one? This previous one. This one. Okay.
Dance, sir. Dance.
Right. Now, this at least you note it down, so that tomorrow it will be easy for you to understand.
Okay, sir.
Yes, sir.
Today, I recommend don't do many things because you can still not do many things here. But only, see, double impact collisions, we have not even started. So if you see such diagrams somewhere, obviously you cannot do such questions. So don't waste time today in such questions. Tomorrow, you will be able to do almost, I think, many questions on collisions. But today, you will not be able to do. So today, it is better to just revise the class notes only.
Okay,
and,
sir.
Or maybe basics of SC Verma you can do. Basic questions from SC Verma. Okay.
We'll see.
Okay, then. I'm ending it now.
Yes, sir. Bye, sir.
Diagrams are shared.
Bye, sir.
Bye, sir.
Bye, sir.
Thank you.